How you all doing? Rocks Original here. Right, so we've got a lovely slab of oak. I've got to plane it, sand it, trim it up to size to fit the form. We're going to be making a nice river table. It's going to have three rivers in it, this one, on the outsides, and finish it off in a nice square coffee table. So yeah, let's crack on, make the form and get everything rolling. So it's been planed, cut, sanded, trimmed up, and now it is ready to fit into the form. Right, so I've got the form made up, just sellotaped up the some OSB. I'm going to place the slab in the centre, put the sides around it, glue it up with hot glue, make sure that it's leak-proof, and then we can start decorating it and pouring our epoxy. Just for a bit of extra security, I'm just going to screw a couple of screws on the underside, just in case the glue does decide to come away from the wood. I doubt it will, but it never has before, but it's always best just to put a couple more screws on the underneath just to keep it stabilised. So yeah, I'm going to crack on with that, and then we're ready. Okay, once you've got the form done and sellotaped up, I've just removed the slab because I'm going to lubricate it now, but I'm going to use this vegetable oil because I'm doing this on the fly, and I've not got all my stuff with me here. This is back at the workshop, so I'm going to use my initiative, and it should be okay with a bit of oil. Should be like a mould release, do you know what I mean? So just going to apply a bit of that all around the sides, and then I'm going to put the slab back in, and then clamp it down, and then start pouring.
Ooh, I love that flight.
Yeah, you could be quite an old. Gotta make some tea. As you can see, the hot glue's held up. Not one leak. Not one leak anywhere. Perfecto. I'm going to start decorating it now. I'm going to put this on a time loop, whatever you call it, time lapse. And yeah, just fly through this. Let's do it.
I feel like my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through. Sometimes it seems the going is just too rough.
Try and say to people, when pouring the epoxy over stuff like shells and moss and anything that's porous, it's going to let off bubbles. So just pour enough just to cover the stuff that you've put in it, no matter what it is. Don't over pour it, because what will happen, all you want to do, you're just sealing everything in, so don't move at this point, because you pour too much, bubbles are going to release. And then you're going to have to start drilling them out or drilling them out, getting rid of them and having to do more work. So bear that in mind when making these. Just pour enough just to get everything covered and locked in. Basically, all you're doing is sealing it in this moment. And then you can start doing the bigger pours after. Okay, so that is phase four complete. This should turn out to be a lovely little coffee table. Really pleased with how it's going so far. It hasn't really given me no problems. So yeah, we're really happy. Let's get this flipped over. I'm on unstable ground, yeah, believe me. Right, so it's all trimmed up now. I'm gonna need to get the track saw on it, but I ain't got the track saw with me. So what I'm gonna do, once I flatten it, I won't be doing anything because I realized I didn't have my circular saw here. So I'll have to take it back in a couple of days and do the track saw.
Right, so we're back at base. Like a donut, I forgot to film the cutting and the trimming up. So what I'm going to do now is I've put some black dye in the grain of the oak. I've wiped it over. I'm going to sand it now, and what's going to happen, the black is going to remain inside the grain, and then once the epoxy goes on it, it's just going to like really pop and come out. Right, so now that that's all done, you want to start laying your seal coat down, and basically this is just to get everything covered, get it in the wood, get it all sealed up, all around the edges, and you will get bubbles at this stage because it's the first actual coat of epoxy going into the wood, which is porous. So when you pour epoxy into wood or anything that's porous, it will push air out from it and then first creating bubbles. So that is the rule of thumb. Try not to pour too much epoxy, and then that will save you less digging out and sanding after. You will see in a minute how many bubbles will appear from the wood compared to the epoxy, because the epoxy is already sealed, so there's no air coming out of the epoxy compared to the wood. So as you can see here, they're everywhere, but you blowtorch them, they disappear. And they will return within like 30 seconds, they'll be back. So there's no point keep going over it, you might as well just leave it and then wait for it to cure up, and then the next day just sand them, deal with it, dig them out, go over it with a wire brush, or that's the way I do it anyway. It's easier than to dremel each individual one out. I probably poured a little bit too much of epoxy for the first seal coat, but I'm okay with that because this is the way I do them, and this is the, I've always had the best results this way. So yeah, let's crack on. Next day, you see the bubbles are still there, but I'll just give it a quick sand. You can see there, look, where porous is, sucked the life out of that epoxy on that part. But that's okay, this is what the first pour is all about, the seal coat. Lucky really, I did pour as much as I did really, but yeah, no problem, just sand these down, bish bash bosh, second coat, and we're good to go. Right, let's get that second seal coat on. Okay, so I must point out, every time that you sand it, spray it up with isopropyl alcohol and wipe it all around and get rid of all the residue as much as possible. And also do that in between sanding as well when you are polishing it. I didn't film that bit, I left them bits out. I forgot to do it basically. So I'm just going to evenly get this spread out as best as I can, because it will make the job a lot easier when sanding it before you have to polish it. So try and get it all around the edges just like before, and just do it as best as you can basically. And then once it cures up, you'll be ready to sand it and then finally get it all polished up. So yeah, let's crack on and see how it turns out.
With a 3, 4 or 5 night all-inclusive voyage from Southampton in August 2024. Your magical adventure awaits.
Okay, so we're going to sand this up now and then get it ready for polishing. I'm going to fast forward all this because sanding takes so long and it takes up so much video time, so let's fast forward. Right, I've got it up to, this is 600 grit. So what I'll do, instead of just keep filming it, I'll show you 800, then 1,000 and then 2,000. So you should see it start going up like in clarity. All right. So this is now at 800 grit. You can see a slight difference, but not a lot. So I've got the 1,000 grit ready and the 2,000 grit, and then after that is when I'll polish. I will give you a quick demonstration on the 2,000 grit, just how long one pass takes, and then you can see.
You can see there, it's getting clearer. That is it. Grit, oh yeah, 1,000 there. 1,000 grit. A little spot. Do this in between every time you sand. So. Right, so I've had a few more goes, and the last one there is 2,000. So I'm going to give you a quick demonstration. Just one pass.
That's one pass, and then wipe it down. Now, this is what I'm going to tell you. Right, so there's a white residue right there, like a sanding pattern. See it? Now, that's through the sandpaper. So that's through the sandpaper clogging up and then gripping on that and causing that pigtail. So get your alcohol spray if you've got it. If not, water. I'm going to use alcohol. Wipe that down. Squirt a bit of that on it. Probably didn't have to do it that long, but I just done it just to be sure. Should be gone. You see there's no editing involved. And there you go, it's gone. And you sometimes you get little see-through ones that you might not catch. Like I've got them here. Do you know what I mean? So that's my own fault for not, because I was went off the track with demonstrating it to you, I forgot to keep wiping it. But so yeah, little tricks there for you, little tips that you might have not seen on YouTube. Okay, so for this part I've got the 3M Fast Cut Plus Perfect It. I've got the Meguiar's polish, and I've got the Farcella G3 wax protection. I'm going to use a wall pad to start off with, and then I'm going to use the black sponge, and then I'm going to use my finishing 3M. It's like a wall pad, but it's a very fine one, and that's just like a for detailing automotive paintwork jobs, but you can use it on epoxy. So yeah, let's crack on with the demonstration. Luckily I checked it, because I started polishing it, then I realized it wasn't filming, so I'm just going to start again and show you how you would start off. So you're going to start off on a slow speed, just getting the polish, the compound, cutting compound, massaged into the epoxy, and then you start speeding up as you go along. Once it's all massaged into the epoxy, then you start going side to side like I'm doing now, and get to the top, and then you come up and down, get to the other end, and then once you get to the other end, then you come round the edges, and you go around your edges. Once you've done a complete square, you go side to side again, and then up and down, and then you just keep repeating that procedure, and that method is called the picture frame method, and that's what they use in the automotive industry when they are polishing paintwork jobs on cars. Right, so I just finished it off with the little black detailing pad. And yeah, I'm pleased with how it's turned out. It's come out lovely. It's come out lovely and clear. I'm happy with that. Really nice. And I've got to do the underneath now. I've just got to remove the drip marks, but it's only on sellotape. So I did have a few little tricky bits at the end. I had to redo it a couple of times, bits I didn't film. I had to pour another 3 coats of epoxy on it because I sanded it and it went through to the wood. So I obviously didn't put enough on it. So that was a couple of problems. But I got there in the end, and I must say it was well worth it. It's really come out nice, and I couldn't be more happy with it. It's a lovely piece of oak. And yeah, that black that I put in the grain really done it some favours. As you can see, like, it's just popped now, and you've got them dark lines in there. I'm not really a fan of light wood. I like natural wood. I don't stain my wood at all, but I do put little bits in the grain sometimes, dark dye, just to highlight it all, or I might scorch it with a blowtorch. So yeah, let's show you the final piece after I've done this little bit here on the underneath. Right, so now that I've stamped it, I did actually forget to stamp it before I poured the epoxy that was on the bottom. So I just routed out a little circle freehand and then stamped it, put some UV resin in it, just cured it up. And what I've done, I've put some filters in the threaded inserts, just in case it tries to mess with the bolts in any way. And then I'm just going to lacquer the bottom. No need to start mucking about polishing and doing the bottom, because let's face it, no one's going to be looking under the bottom. But I did think it was best to just tidy it up and make it look nice and neat. And also it'll look better from the other side in case you want to put a light behind it or something. And yeah, it just basically finishes it off and makes it complete. So if you took anything away from this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon.